Hey.
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 You know what? For like the last 5 years, we've come to this stand at the NAMM show. We've gone, is there anything new, Christoph? He's gone, no, there's nothing new. So that's been the shortest video of the whole show.
Yeah.
So 2019, Christoph, is there anything new?
Yes.
Yay!
You have some. So actually, the first thing that we see is our new, prototype of an editor.
Oh, that is great.
Right?
So you'll be able to edit everything from an editor?
Yes, because that is what you would expect from it.
That's what people want. Yeah.
And that's what people want.
Yeah.
And yes, you can edit everything.
Yeah.
From the editor.
That's so cool, because I think a lot of people are nice for that.
And
So when you do anything, you can see it's hooked up to that.
Oh yeah, it is. It does this. It's magic.
Simple things.
Second magic.
Two-way magic.
And where's?
Hello.
This is Georg, and he will show us the morphing.
Okay.
Because it looks it looks so good.
Let's have a look. Let's see it.
Okay, morphing
and,
is very
and
easy.
Actually, he's the guy who did the editor.
Just need to press the option key.
It's him.
And then they move the knob. And by doing that, you define the morphing range. So the start and the end value. You can adjust it afterwards. By releasing the option key, you can adjust the start value. By pressing, you can adjust the end value. And now if I go over here, with the expression pedal, you can control them. And to turn it off, just move the start point over the end point. By doing this, and you're done. So very easy to set up, and you have a clear overview about what's going on.
Cool. So that's two things.
It's our cabinet.
Ooh. Hardware. We love hardware.
Yeah, it's real hardware. It's so hard that it's passive. It's a passive cabinet. I mean, we have profilers with power amp, as you guys know.
Yeah.
And yeah, it's a passive cabinet. But the nice thing is it's. It contains a broadband speaker. It's a bespoke speaker made by Celestion exclusively for us.
Did you have some part in designing that speaker?
Yes.
Excellent.
Oh yes, we.
So, in what way did you voice it differently to say a traditional guitar speaker?
It is behaving like a guitar speaker, especially in terms of the dispersion pattern. So it has a bit of a beam. It's not that hard as on a full guitar speaker, but it has a bit of a beam, so it always sounds guitar-like, even when it's on the full range sound.
Oh, so it has like a full range option, does it?
Yes. Let's see, this is the new page. The interesting thing here is the whole intelligence is done by the profiler's DSP. It's not in the speaker. Right. It's driven by the DSP, and if you when you run the full range sound, especially the on axis sound is ultra linear.
Right. Okay.
Right. It's really linear because it's driven and corrected by the DSP. Right. And then you have the option to opt out of the full range sound and go for a speaker sound,
mm-hmm.
or a guitar speaker sound, and then the speaker will behave like a guitar speaker in that cabinet, right? And up to now we have 16 what we call speaker imprints.
Yeah.
Right? And range from like Vintage 30, Green Bed, blah, 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 up to something like that. It's an old Oxford speaker that a good friend of ours found on his attic. And yes, really, it's true, because you pretty much can't buy that speaker for money, maybe on eBay,
yeah,
but you can't buy it in a shop or in a cabinet, and but we bring it back to life.
They're great, and let me see how it feels pretty like chunky. It's not like a super lightweight thing.
That's true. It's not a lightweight cap. Let's say it's a normal cap.
I'll just show you there it is. I like the it's slightly angled,
yeah.
A little bit angled. Cool, man. So what else have we got then?
Well, it's not the full story yet. For those that don't like that cabinet.
I like that cabinet.
The way it is, thanks if you like it. We will offer the speakers as a replacement part.
So you can take your own cabinet and put your speakers in there.
Yeah, you can hashtag change your tires.
Nice, right? Hashtag change your tires.
Yeah.
I like it.
And you can put it in any kind of like 12-inch.
So all the holes are in the same place as a regular Celestion speaker.
Oh yeah, sure. It's a regular 12-inch format, and it's all the same. So it fits in every cabinet. So you can change that. You can have a 4x12 by that. But the DSP will drive then all speakers at the same time.
That's amazing.
And you can utilize all the functions.
That's so cool.
Right.
And finally?
Well, the third thing is things that people out there might already know. We have a public beta out with our new reverb algorithms. They will be pretty soon go to a release version. And just a small thing, we have redesigned the way you handle effect presets. So whenever you turn type or browse, it'll open the same page. Like this, you have three columns, which is category, type, and preset. And they all work together in a way, whenever you change the type, you change the start of the preset. And let's see, with that, I change a preset. But you see, I now go up over the boundary, and it'll also change the type column. So it's like very easy to understand and really easy to handle.
So when do you think the speaker cabinets will start to be into the stores?
It might take some time. I mean, the software is done. Pretty much everything is done, but we have to bring this into production. So what we say right now will be third quarter.
Okay.
But hopefully a bit earlier.
That's fantastic.
I thought we could make it in maybe 4 months, but my guy says it might take a bit longer.
Well, you just got to crack that whip a bit harder. Come on.
Yeah, I do, but it's not just them.
It's all good. No, it's great. I'm so pleased. It's like...
Good stuff. Good stuff. Yeah.
Pete says it's good stuff. Is there any chance we could just have a little listen? Are they working? Even if we just play for a second? Or?
Oh, of course.
We shall play out with Monty Pittman on guitar. Thank you so much again. You still make my favorite little green amp profiling units in the whole world. They're very cool.
And I hope that video was not too long.
It's good. When are you coming? I know every year you say you're coming to the UK and then you never do. You're like, but
I think we have an appointment this year. I don't know when, but I heard of that.
It's right? Like trying to tie you down to a date. It's impossible.
So come a little on. Appointment.
All right, well, at some point, we'll get Christoph on the channel. He can talk in more depth and about your life and how you invented all the crazy shit you've invented, because it's interesting. Anyway, we'll play out Monty Pittman on guitar. Thank you, sir. Enjoy the rest of the show. Good luck with everything. Subscribe, like, keep watching all the shit that we keep making.